Exotic equipment in Destiny 2 serves as the foundation for your loadout. With the Ruinous Effigy, things are different. The weapon itself isn't worth your time, it's a pretty standard trace rifle, but what it creates will provide you with power beyond your wildest dreams, and that is definitely worth building around. For today's video, we're going to break down a loadout designed to push the Ruinous Effigy and its spheres to their limits. Let's get started. Whenever a Void Damage exotic weapon is released, the best choice of subclass and exotic armor is simple. The Voidwalker's Bottom Branch, the Attunement of Hunger, and the Nezarak Sin exotic helmet will always be meta picks for Void Damage exotics, and the Effigy is no different. However, with those two things locked in, we can start getting creative with the rest of our mods. Before we do, let's talk about the Effigy. This is an exotic trace rifle, and its perk is Transmutation. When you kill a target, they're turned into a transmutation sphere that you or an ally can pick up. The sphere will stay active on the ground for about 30 seconds, and when picked up, it has 30 ammo that drains 1 ammo per second. The sphere gives you access to 3 separate attacks, all of which drain ammo. On hits, they disorient or suppress enemies in addition to damaging them. It has a chain light attack that deals respectable damage, a guard drain that deals damage to nearby enemies in the radius and heals you as damage is dealt, and reduces your damage taken. Finally, the heavy attack will expend all your ammo for a burst of damage around your character. The Ruinous Effigy and its transmutation spheres are without question the most complex exotic weapon in the game, but we'll talk more about how to optimize play around it in a little bit. For now, we're going to fill out the rest of our build with mods. The spheres created by the Effigy have a much higher potential than the Effigy itself, so our mods are going to focus around increasing our effectiveness when using them. The sphere is essentially a melee weapon, so we want mods to help us in close quarters combat. Reactive Pulse was released in the Season of Arrivals, and it's the perfect fit for this playstyle. While charged with light, taking damage when surrounded by enemies releases a burst of arc energy, consuming one stack. To become charged with light, I'll be using Charge Harvester. Kills and assists have a chance to charge me with light. This means while I'm slaying with the transmutation sphere, I'll have a chance to charge myself with light. And when that happens, there's a good chance I'll be surrounded by enemies, which means Reactive Pulse will activate and kill everything. I also have Stacks on Stacks equipped, so I generate 2 charges every time I become charged. Finally, I still have one more slot, and I'm going to use it to further push my character in the direction of being a CQC juggernaut. Lucent Blade has the effect dealing damage with a sword increases your sword damage for 5 seconds and consumes 1 stack of charged with light. Since I'm using Lucent Blade, I have to have a sword equipped in my heavy slot, so I'll be using the Fallen Guillotine. Now that we know about all the components of the build, we're going to continue breaking things down further so we get a better understanding of how they all work together. Before we head out into the field to look at the build in action, we're going to look a little bit closer at some of the mods and weapons that I have equipped. Lucent Blade and Reactive Pulse both have secondary perks that are active in the build. Reactive Pulse has Finisher Bulwark, gain a powerful overshield while performing your finisher. With this build, I don't use finishers that much, but Finisher Bulwark is still incredibly powerful when combined with Devour. So let's say I'm running really low on health and I absolutely need to kill an enemy, I can trigger my finisher and give myself a massive overshield to protect me while the finisher is going off, and then once the finisher is done, the overshield goes away, but my health will be brought back to maximum because of Devour. It's a very cool combination. Next up, Lucent Blade has Replenishing Guard as its second perk, greatly increases the charge rate of your equipped swords. This, in tandem with the Fallen Guillotine roll that I have with Swordsmanship Guard, will allow me to use my heavy attack a lot more often. It's about every 3 seconds the sword energy will recharge back to maximum, compared to about 5 seconds with Heavy Guard and no Replenishing Guard mod. So it's a difference. It's not a huge difference, and it doesn't come into play too much, but it is something nice to have when you do find yourself in a situation where you can spam your heavy attack. Alright folks, for today's testing, we're diving into the Warden of Nothing Nightfall Strike in the classic Nightfall playlist. We're jumping into the middle of things, and we're going to get right into the action. There's a lot of stuff to talk about with the Ruinous Effigy and the spheres that it creates, so let's start talking about it. The first thing that is very valuable for this weapon is its ability to crowd control enemies. Anytime I deal damage with either the light attack, the guard drain effect, or the heavy attack, it is going to suppress or disorient the enemies. And that is going to allow me to continue applying pressure to them. So keep in mind that even though the spheres don't do crazy damage when you hit with the light attack and when you're raising the guard, the damage over time is not something ridiculous. It's not out of control. It's providing you with crowd control, and that's going to be incredibly valuable. Because not only is that taking pressure off you, but if you're playing with a group, it's taking pressure off your team as well. Moving into this next area, I've got to make another sphere for myself, and I've also got to reproc Devour. Not him. Him. And now that I've got it, I can make my way into combat. But what I want to do first is guard against his pushback. And I'll use the heavy attack to burst him down, and then we'll finish him off with the effigy to create another sphere for myself, and then I can just use the guard drain to eliminate these enemies. The way that they were positioned, it was kind of difficult for me to use the light attack, so I used the mitigation from the guard drain and the healing that it provides to basically just move around and tick the enemies down slowly. This next bit is going to be a little bit challenging. There's enemies hit pretty tough over here. You can see that even while I'm raising the guard, I'm not unkillable. I do still take damage. And if there are a lot of enemies shooting at me simultaneously, then I'm certainly going to die if I'm not careful. Got a bit of a firing squad situation coming up over here as well. Let's put down the rift. I'm waiting for the train to go by. I'm just going to pick this up and immediately slam it. We'll send out a Nova Bomb for the Hydra. Get rid of him for another sphere. And more enemies should spawn in over here in just a second. Yes, they are. I'm just going to heavy slam them. And then these guys down here. Before I go in, I'm going to activate Devour, get my reload going. And then the reactive pulse actually triggered and finished them all off. We got another wave spawning. I'll wait for the wave to spawn. And these guys I can hit with the light attacks. And then let's see if I can get a nice hit. I saw that Minotaur down there. We'll throw out the grenade. We'll turn him into a sphere. This guy looks like he wants to have a punching contest with me, but that is not going to end in his favor. The light attack is a bit more efficient than the guard drain. The guard drain uses a lot of the ammo for the weapon or the timer for the weapon. So I try to use a mixture of them both to get as much value out of the weapon as I can. I really wanted to get that sphere there. That was a potentially dangerous scenario. The guard drain ability on the sphere works the same way the sword guard works, so you can use it to mitigate the damage from enemy stomps, and then you can follow up with either light attacks, you can just continue to hold the guard drain to be safe, or you can use the heavy attack and then switch over to a heavy weapon or whatever you're going to do. When we come into contact with more mini bosses and even bosses, I will also show off a little bit of Unguard, because I haven't been using it that much in here so far. I mostly use Unguard against champions, and there are no champions in here right now, but I'll see if I can use it on the wanted enemy that's going to come up in just a little bit. This bit is really going to push to the limits the defensive capabilities of the spheres and the guard drain. Let's stay in cover for a moment. I'm going to have to put up my rift and get the reload from back here. There's my sphere. Going to go get it immediately. The wanted enemy is really the biggest pain in the ass that is in this area. So I want to take him out. So let's just keep that guard up for a second. So now you see the wanted enemy is... Uh-oh. The wanted enemy did get disoriented from the sphere, and that allowed me to burst him down in a pretty safe way. But at the same time, the other enemies were doing quite a lot of damage, so I almost ended up dying in that situation anyway, which would have been a little bit embarrassing. This next area is really busy, and there's a lot of damage that goes out, so I'm going to spend a lot of my time just using the guard drain ability, if I can even find the sphere, because there's just so much going on here, and it's kind of difficult to really focus on light attacks or heavy attacks, so I'm just going to use that as much as I can to keep myself safe from all the chaos. And then, of course, the reactive pulse is going to proc occasionally and do a big burst of damage as well. Oh, messed up there. Let's just slam because it looks cool. For this next bit, we are going to have to do a bit of objective defense. There's going to be a bunch of enemies coming out of doors that are spread around the room, and I'm going to have to stand on a point. But before I stand on the point, I want to clear out some of the enemies. The reactive pulse actually activating before all the enemies even came out of the door. I have to make sure to chow down for devour. Use our guard drain because there's three guys clustered close together. These red bars, I'll just punch them with the light attack. We got 45 seconds before we actually have to go stand on the objective. Throw out a grenade. Oh, I ran out of time. I thought I was going to have a bit more time to possibly use the drain instead of going for the heavy slam, but I should have just done that instead. It's very, very important to, when you see the clock ticking down on your sphere, right before it gets to zero, try to use that slam, because that's going to be the most efficient use of your ammunition with the sphere. So like right now we've got 19, 15, 10, 3, 2, 1, slam. Always want to try and get that slam out to hit as many targets as you can before you run out of duration on the sphere. Just beat that boy up. Still got 20 seconds before we have to get to the point. What I want to do here is slam the mini boss, then chop him, and I can use my sword on the rest of them. Make another sphere. I can actually just pick this up and hold the guard and tank a lot of shots, but you don't heal with guard drain unless you are damaging an enemy, so that's something to keep in mind. We do have another Minotaur on the field, so I want to get rid of him. My Devourer ran out at a really inopportune time. Had to chow down real quick there before I died. Okay. So far, so good. Yet another mini boss is coming out, but this one is actually immune to the effects of suppression. So I have to be a lot smarter about how I deal with him. I'm not going to use my Nova. I think I can do it without the Nova. Just have to make a sphere. And then... Ooh, this hurts. This hurts real bad. Oh, get me out of here. Get me out of here. I said I wasn't going to use the Nova. I used the Nova. It had to be done. I mean, that was just a bit much, wasn't it? Coming into the final boss, we are going to see the biggest weakness of the Ruinous Effigy overall is that it doesn't do incredible amounts of DPS, and even the sphere is not a DPS powerhouse. It's almost, if you would imagine a sword as a special weapon, that is almost the exact damage output that you get from the transmutation sphere. So it's not great, but it's also not bad. But what I really want to do going into this boss fight is make use of Unguard and the Lucent Blade effects on the boss as much as I can. It's a little bit difficult. This boss fight is difficult, but let's see if we can make something work. This is one of those bosses where if you don't kill him in 2 seconds, then the rest of the fight is a pain in the ass. But so we're gonna start off with a sphere. We obviously can't disorient the boss, but what we can do is wait for him to do his slam, which he will do eventually. Are you gonna do it? What are you doing? That's what I was waiting for him to do. Ooh, he teleported right as I was about to hit him with that unguard. I've got to let my sword energy restore itself before I put the sword away. Because if you use a heavy attack when your sword energy is low, then it won't do its full damage. So as soon as the boss is done doing that... Oh, that's exciting. I actually get to tank that attack? All right. I got a little bit too greedy and I wound up dying. I was trying to push the limits of the guard drain just to see how much it could really take. And it can take a lot of punishment. It was able to. And there we go. That's going to do it for the build for today. The Ruinous Effigy is a very pleasant surprise. It's a creative exotic, but it's one that is also powerful, not simply because it does good damage, but it provides defense, and defensive options are something that is sorely lacking in Destiny 2, and the Ruinous Effigy is a push in the right direction. The guard drain ability is, without a doubt, my favorite aspect of the weapon and the spheres, and it's something I would love to see more of on legendary weapons and exotic armor, things that increase your defensive prowess so you can move away from offense and still feel as if you are a force to be reckoned with on the battlefield. With all of that said, we are going to wrap things up here, but don't worry, there's plenty more coming in the future. So as always, if you enjoyed this video and you'd like to support the channel more than you already do just by watching, liking, subscribing, and commenting, you can head over to patreon.com/iBlueAirJGR to become a patron. As always, the name of the game is Destiny 2, the name of the channel is iBlueAirJGR. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.